Hello everyone, thank you for joining me. My name is Himanshu Sharma. I'm a certified web analyst. I help businesses in fixing their Google Analytics and conversion issues. Today I'm going to explain the concept of conversion in the context of multi-channel funnels and attribution modeling. This will not only help you in understanding the various multi-channel funnel reports in Google Analytics, but also help you in understanding the buying behavior of your website visitors, and above all, help you in determining the most effective marketing channels for investment. So what is conversion? In the context of Google Analytics, conversion means website goals or objectives. Conversion is what your website is trying to achieve. There can be one or many purposes for which a website has been set up. These purposes can be something like selling products, generating leads, branding, selling advertising, building good relationship with target audience, providing customer support, etc. So if one of your website goals is to get signups for your newsletters, then number of newsletter signups is your conversion. Similarly, if one of your website goal is to generate sales or e-commerce transaction on your website, then number of e-commerce transaction is your conversion. When a conversion is directly tied to a transaction, it is called a transactional conversion. For example, e-commerce transaction is a transactional conversion. When a conversion is not directly tied to a transaction, it is called a non-transactional conversion. For example, newsletter signups is a non-transactional conversion. A non-transactional conversion is referred to as goal conversion in Google Analytics. So we have got two types of conversions, transactional conversions and non-transactional conversions. In multi-channel funnel reports, whenever we talk about conversions, we are referring to the sum of transactional and non-transactional conversions. Both transactional and non-transactional conversions can be further classified into macro and micro conversions. The major purpose of setting up a website is known as macro conversion, and other minor purposes is known as the micro conversion. For example, if your main purpose of setting up a website is to generate sales, then number of e-commerce transactions is your macro conversion. The other minor purposes like newsletter sign-up, building user engagement, providing customer support, etc. are your micro conversions. Both macro and micro conversions can be further classified into direct and assisted conversions. So we can have two categories of macro conversions, direct macro conversion and assisted macro conversion. Similarly, we can have two categories of micro conversions, direct micro conversions and assisted micro conversion. In the context of Google Analytics, direct micro conversion are those major website goals which are directly achieved by a marketing channel. For example, when a user clicks on a paid search ad and make a purchase straight away, then it means the paid search marketing channel directly achieved a major website goal, and hence the goal or conversion completed by the paid search marketing channel is referred to as direct macro conversion in Google Analytics multi-channel funnel reports. Now, what are assisted macro conversions? In the context of Google Analytics, assisted macro conversions are those major website goals which are indirectly achieved by a marketing channel. For example, when a user clicks on a paid search ad but later returns to your website via organic search to make a purchase, then in that case, the paid search marketing channel only helps in achieving a major website goal. Or in other words, it indirectly achieved a major website goal, and hence the goal or conversion assisted by the paid search marketing channel would then be referred to as assisted macro conversion in Google Analytics. So whether a conversion would be referred to as assisted or direct by Google Analytics actually depend upon the role a marketing channel played in the conversion path. Both direct and assisted conversions are relevant only when used alongside a marketing channel. As a standalone matrix, they are meaningless. For example, 200 assisted macro conversions do not mean anything on their own. They make sense only when used to analyze and report the performance of a marketing channel. Now, what are direct micro conversions? In the context of Google Analytics, direct micro conversions are those minor website goals which are directly achieved by a marketing channel. For example, when a user clicks on a paid search ad and signs up for your newsletter straight away, then it means the paid search marketing channel directly achieved a minor website goal, and hence the goal or conversion completed by the paid search marketing channel would be called direct micro conversion. Assisted micro conversions, on the other hand, are those minor website goals which are indirectly achieved by a marketing channel. For example, when a user clicks on a paid search ad but later return to your website via organic search to sign up for your newsletter, then in that case, the paid search marketing channel only helped in achieving a minor website goal. Or in other words, it indirectly achieved a minor website goal, and hence the goal or conversion assisted by the paid search marketing channel would then be referred to as assisted micro conversion in Google Analytics multi-channel reports. So whether a conversion would be referred to as assisted or direct by Google Analytics actually depend upon the role a marketing channel played in the conversion path. So that's how you can understand conversions in the context of multi-channel funnels and attribution modeling, which can help you in understanding the various multi-channel funnel reports in Google Analytics, as well as help you in determining the most effective marketing channels for investment. Alright guys, that's all for now. If you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel and share it with others. Thank you for showing up. I hope to see you soon. Take care. Bye.